Okay, so
your husband had a transient ischemic attack
a month ago, and he has, it seems like he had a very small thing in his brain, and he was smoking and drinking. He stopped already.
Okay.
He still has pins and needles feeling on his right hand side of his body. He's recovering from his leg. He has recovered his leg sensation in his leg, but he still has the this feeling in his right hand side and face. So, is there, you know, he did a little bit of the paleo diet with me. He goes on and off. He's going to do it more. He has a little bit of a little bit of cholesterol, just not much, and he has a little bit of high blood pressure. He has one kidney. Besides that, I think he's okay.
Okay. What's your question?
So the question is,
I'm sorry that you're going through that, but
how, yeah, I know,
what,
I know.
What can, okay. What can we do?
Okay, so first, if you know of a doctor, you know, a different kind of doctor that you can advise to see, or, and if you can give like a general ideas of nutrition or like a general idea to start looking into.
Sure. I can't help on the doctor front. I mean, I certainly know some people who are, who I talk to about nutrition a lot, but I mm-hmm. think when you're talking about this, mm-hmm. then you want to find the intersection of that with someone who really specializes in the condition. And mm-hmm. I don't know, and I just don't know enough doctors mm-hmm. who are doing that kind of work. Mm-hmm. Hold on, there's, I saw someone saying that they lost sound. Could other people, can someone in the chat let us know whether you can still hear both of us? Okay. Yeah. Okay. So it was a temporary sound glitch, but it's back. Okay. Perfect. Okay. What I can say though, is that although I'm not an expert in the specific condition of the transient ischemic attack, ischemia is when the blood supply gets cut off, and it's very, very similar to what is happening in a heart attack, where, mm-hmm. and the reasons for these events differ in mm-hmm. people, but in general, the most common reason for what we think of as a heart attack is ischemia, but it's in the coronary arteries. Mm-hmm. And also an ischemic stroke is a larger event. A TIA, a transient ischemic attack, is like a mini stroke. Mm-hmm. But they all kind of fall into the same category, where the development of plaque is mm-hmm. a very significant part, is the major thing mm-hmm. predisposing you to having an event like that. And I know in my grandmother had a transient ischemic attack, and she was very lucky to have the TIA, because when she was in the hospital for it, they realized that she had a 97% blockage in her coronary arteries. Mm-hmm. And they fixed that, and mm-hmm. she could have wound up with a fatal heart attack otherwise. So I tell that only to illustrate the parallels of how, if mm-hmm. that happens, you probably have atherosclerosis going on.
Mm-hmm.
And so probably, and certainly it's the case that getting the blood pressure under control is going to be another very important factor. But I think nutritionally, the major factors in blood pressure are, potassium is the biggest one, the mm-hmm. salt to potassium ratio, not eating too much. Some people are salt sensitive, some aren't. But the major factor is really the salt to potassium ratio. Some of the other minerals like magnesium and calcium are important, but then stress and physical activity are huge in blood pressure as well. So assuming that's under control, the main nutritional factors that you want to pay attention to are things that get the blood lipids under control, and then things that get the process of calcification and inflammation under control.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And really, you could copy and paste a protocol for dealing with protection against heart disease onto this.
Mm-hmm.
And basically that means, so I'll do the non-cholesterol stuff first because mm-hmm. that's the less obvious stuff. So vitamin K2 is very important for protecting the blood vessels from calcification. Mm-hmm. Magnesium is important and vitamin A is important. So you, are these things familiar to you or should I talk about?
I do. You are familiar
with these. Okay. Yes. So I think those are the big nutrient factors when we're thinking about calcification. Mm-hmm. But then the blood lipids is super important too. So you mentioned is cholesterol. What is that like?
Very, very little. No, it's, I mean, I don't have the
figure. Or it's high, but not that high.
It's a little bit high only. It's a little bit high. Okay. Really high.
All right. So maybe the cholesterol is in his main factor. Mm-hmm. What you really want to think about these different, I would say the other thing is antioxidant protection. Mm-hmm. So, you know, the reason that the lipids are problematic is because they're getting damaged by free radicals and other damaging molecules. So things like vitamin C and E, glutathione, fruits and vegetables supplying polyphenols, mm-hmm. all the minerals like zinc, copper, iron, manganese, selenium, all those things are important.
So it's natural sources, preferably.
What's his diet like? Because preferably what you want is to...
Well, it used to be pasta every day with, like an Italian kind of... That's what it used to be.
So look, I mean, figuring out whatever the limiting factor is and managing the details is a really big project. Like mm-hmm. there are some simple rules of thumb, like... getting regular exercise, providing that the doctor okays it, obviously mm-hmm. with cardiovascular issues, you have to do that. Mm-hmm. But whatever is safe for him to engage in, mm-hmm. if needed, meditation or stress reduction on the blood pressure, and then just cut the junk food out and include a well-balanced diet. I mean, that's the simple thing, right? Mm-hmm. If you want to go deeper than that, then you really need to start looking at more comprehensively about, is he missing any nutrients? Mm-hmm. One of the things that a simple way to do that is who makes his food? Is it you or is it?
I make the food. Yeah.
So if you make the food, then, you know, put what you're making into Chronometer, which is a food tracking mm-hmm. app. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Do it correctly. See mm-hmm. if there's any missing nutrients that stand out. That's, mm-hmm. that's the simplest way to say like, mm-hmm. geez, maybe he's missing something. Mm-hmm. Other than that, if you really want to dig into the case, you need to do a lot of testing. Mm-hmm. But if you're in control of the food, just mm-hmm. Starting by analyzing what you're feeding him mm-hmm. and seeing what's missing.
Well, the thing is that I cook and then he orders some days and some days. You know what I mean?
Right. Okay. So that's a behavioral management issue.
He's going to see your video after this, so, okay.
All right, okay, perfect. Thank you, Alejandra.